Hi, Sammy Barefoot Groove out here in the beautiful backyard. Talking to you about Cajon and how to make music out of this box. Okay, maybe some of you don't know that actually Cajon means just that, okay? It looks like a box. You can't really put a lot of stuff inside of it because there's only a small hole in the back, but it's a box nonetheless. This particular Cajon utilizes some guitar strings right behind this front panel, and they're attached here, and they go down, come back up, make sort of a W shape, and they're wrapped around two little posts down here that can be adjusted with an Allen wrench or a hexagonal wrench. That allows us to get a tighter or looser sound from the strings in there, which give us the snare drum type effect. Today, how we're making music out of this box is through accents and taps. If we played trumpet, piano, guitar, any more melodic, or should I say melody-based instruments, then we'd be talking more about key signatures, chord progressions, scales. Instead, when it comes to battery or percussion that is not pitched, like the xylophone or the marimba or the timpani, then we use a combination of accents and taps. It's all about dynamics and rhythm, okay? So in terms of the Cajon, we have a couple of different sounds. I like to approach the Cajon from a very relaxed and natural approach so that I can play very fast and for long periods of time. Some of my gigs are 4 hours, and though I do take a few breaks, that's a long time to be slapping the wood and the cymbals with the bare hand. Yeah. I tend to keep the hand kind of closed for the bass sounds. So sort of closed hand right in the center of the box there. And the further away from the box I approach, or the closer, affects the dynamic, okay? So that way I can create accents and taps. Same thing up in my snare region, only I'm not using the whole hand up here to get the snare sound. I get a lot of different sounds depending on where I play the box, but right now I'm focusing on sort of the kick and the snare regions of the Cajon, you know, as we're kind of thinking about it as sort of kick, snare in the box. Here, I think about just past that first knuckle on the hand, okay? So, I'm really thinking about just that much, okay? Just that much. And for the slaps, even less. Just these last three fingers. Now, the index finger gets in there, but I'm not really thinking about that so much. I'm just relaxing, so it flops in there as well. Nice blast. So this is the way I can achieve drum set-like grooves or tones out of the Cajon in a situation where a drum set might not be feasible due to the dynamics of the room or the space of the stage that we're playing on. You know, if you're out there playing in the scene like I am, that sometimes the stage is little more than a drum riser. Sometimes it's just a corner in the restaurant and they want you to be super quiet. So that's where a lot of times these ideas can come in handy. All right, you didn't think I'd be talking much about stick technique in a video about Cajon, because, you know, we're not playing the Cajon with our drumsticks, obviously. We're playing those with our bare hands. And for those of you who are also stick players, drum set players, maybe you're in high school drumline, maybe you're in college drumline, maybe you are a rudimental drummer that applies the rudiments to drum set, or whatever it is you do. I like to apply the rudiments to everything. They are my chords and scales. And so in this case, I'm really thinking about an accent versus a tap, okay, so stick height, and I allow gravity to do a lot of this work for me. So for my taps, just dropping the sticks onto the hi-hat there, and for the accent, I just pick the stick up higher, and I get a louder sound. So that's just gravity. I don't have to put any force into the stroke to get that loud sound. So how does this relate to the Cajon? in the middle of the box, I get my bass tone, and up in the corners, I get more of a snare-like sound, okay? So I often refer to these sounds as my kick and my snare. And again, I'm using gravity, okay? I don't have to hit hard. Never, ever hit it hard. That will result in injury, okay? Don't hurt yourself. Don't play through the pain. Okay, that's not what this is about, all right? We should be having fun, we should be relaxed. Allowing gravity to create the sound, not force. Okay, so here's a nice open bass stroke. Here's some accents in the snare region. Now, let's compare that to no gravity. I guess I shouldn't say zero gravity, but basically I'm just going to use my wrist to tap on the box as opposed to actually getting a big accent with the full weight of my arm. So, taps, accents. So let's put this into an application, accent tap exercise. So let's apply that to the cajon. Cannot overstress the importance of playing every pattern, both right hand lead and left hand lead. This became even more important to me as I started to develop patterns through the cajon and the hi-hat, realizing that sometimes I might play the hi-hat with my foot and dedicate both hands to the cajon, whereas other times I may dedicate one hand to a shaker, a tambourine, or even the stick on the hi-hat to create similar patterns. So it's really important that I be able to play all of these sounds equally well and with ease in both hands, okay? So let's apply accents and taps now into an actual groove, okay? This is just a 4-4 groove. Now notice, I started this groove right hand lead, so all of the accents happen in the right hand. It's just 1E and a, 2E and a, 3E and a, 4E and a, 1. And so the left hand is all in the wrist. That's all just taps coming out of the wrist. And with the right hand, I'm allowing the right hand to really use gravity, use the full weight of the arm to create the louder notes. Now let's see, what if I just play it all as taps and keep it all really quiet? It doesn't have the same effect as I'm allowed to use hi-hats, I'm gonna play the groove like this. I don't have hi-hats, or if I'm going for a different effect, I may keep it all in the box, accenting with the hi-hat or with not at all. Have to get such a loud sound. I can still use this effect to varying degrees depending on the dynamic level that is right for the musical situation. These are just a few ways that we can use accents and taps to make music out of the cajon, using gravity to create the sound rather than force. I hope you enjoyed this video. Tell me what you think down in the comments below. I've got links to this Tycoon percussion in the description below, so be sure and check that out. Like, share, and subscribe. Go barefoot, get groove.